AI made me cry. ChatGPT is a better listener than a real person who doesn't know NVC. That's what I found out. It's free, available anytime, and ready to help you feel heard. Let me show you 5 hacks to make it work perfectly for you. So chatgpt.com is a website where, amongst other things, you can have conversations with a bot. And research has shown that these chatbots can actually help people who are, for example, on a waiting list for therapy, but also if you don't want to disclose certain things to a therapist, if you don't have money for a professional listener at the moment, or if you just feel like ranting for 3 hours and you don't want to be worried that someone gets bored, this can be very helpful. I'm an NVC trainer with over 10 years of experience, and in the past years I've used ChatGPT as a listener for myself, kind of on and off, but in the past weeks, in order to make this video, I've used it daily, testing different prompts against other prompts to see what really gives quality responses. My criteria for quality being that I want to have a sense of being heard, I want to get insights about myself, I want to have a physical release or emotional release like tears, and I want to feel some enthusiasm from the other side in exploring together with me. So in my test, I'm assuming there is no emergency, like there's no domestic abuse, there's no deeply depressive thoughts. If that's what's going on, I would recommend either a professional or at least a helpline that you can find online. And similarly, this is not a replacement for professional listener, professional therapist. I would still recommend you to work with me or someone else that you trust if there's more going on. This video is for educational purposes only. So hack number one, I read everywhere online that your prompts need to be very lengthy, very detailed, but I'm gonna tell you, this is not needed. So I literally typed, listen to me with NVC. And then it was enough for ChatGPT to not give me any advice, to actually give a proper reflection, to, as you can see here, guess some feelings, guess some needs. And it actually also ticks the box, so that this made me feel heard, first of all. And it also ticked the box of asking me some further questions. Would it help to explore these feelings and concerns further, or is there something specific you feel would bring you some comfort or direction right now? And so that was inviting to me to explore further. Now, I did feel that ChatGPT sounded a little bit formal and a little bit like coming from a book. So I just gave it a few tweaks. So basically I said, would you do that again, but speak more informally? And then it was actually doing that. Some other tweaks you could make, and I'll put all these prompts in the description box so you can just copy paste them so you don't need to make any notes. You could say, ask 5 to 7 clarifying questions to ensure a clear understanding, because ChatGPT is never going to tell you, I don't know, I don't understand you. So it's just going to guess, right? And so far it's usually guessing right, but if you feel like you're very vague, you might want to do that. You can say, I might like advice, but ask me whether I want advice before giving it. But generally, if you say NVC, it's not going to give you advice. So you could say, I only want you to guess needs. And you could say, give me appreciation, right? You could just share what you did today and just say, could you give me some appreciation? Or you could share a conflict you're having and you're trying to do your best and you just want to hear some appreciation. Hack number two, if you actually want to have a full dialogue, you don't just want one response, you want to have a full dialogue. So you could just say, could we continue like having a dialogue? It's as simple as that. And then it's what ChatGPT is actually doing. And it's working, as you can see here. It gives me tears. So the emotional release was happening. And here's something else happened, which is very interesting. I asked ChatGPT, do you think I'm too critical with myself? I was trying to make a decision about what to do with a friend who had lied to me. And I was just having a hard time deciding what I wanted to say, what I wanted to do. And then ChatGPT said, it also seems like you're, yes, you're being too critical. And it also seems like you're putting a lot of pressure on yourself to find the right answer. The quotation marks were also made by ChatGPT. And I was like, damn, that's exactly what's happening. I'm putting pressure on myself to make the perfect, to find the perfect answer. Again, this gives me tears. So that was really an insight, actually. That was very interesting. Hack number three is that every time you open the web page, ChatGPT will automatically start in a new chat. But I would recommend for all these chats that you're going to do about, you know, anything you want to share about, to click on the old chat on the left and continue there, because ChatGPT remembers everything you shared before. There is one caveat in the free version, so everything I'm saying is about the free version. It only remembers 3,000 words, which is about 6 A4s. So that means that you can do a little hack there. All you need to do is just say, can you summarize what we discussed so far in a concise manner so that you can remember everything as we move forward? And I did that. I tried it. Worked perfectly. It summed up everything we discussed that week, and we could move on with ChatGPT remembering. And so ChatGPT will remember that you told it that you have ADHD, that someone passed away in your surroundings. Everything will be remembered. Hack number four is about privacy. Now, this is kind of an issue with ChatGPT. I'm not gonna lie to you. I really dove into this. And okay, that being said, it's similar to when you put things into a search bar, also when you're emailing stuff. We just shouldn't consider things to be private online. That's the main gist that I was getting from people advising me about this. Some people said, yeah, you could set up a VPN, you could use an anonymous email address, but most people said all of that doesn't really help. All you need to think about is that whatever you share is not really private. And so what that means is that obviously don't say anything illegal that you did, but also think about stuff like when it comes to, for example, insurances or getting government support. Like, say that you're at home, you told the government that you cannot walk, but at the same time you're searching, I don't know, a skiing holiday. I'm just making up something, right? So these kind of like tricky things, just make sure that you think about that a little bit. If you're just sharing about, you know, feeling sad about a conflict, I don't think there's any, you know, going to be any problem about that. But just generally, you want to be aware of this. If you would like a fully privacy safe self-connection process, watch this video in which I guide you through a 5-minute practice that doesn't require any online apps. Hack number five is that if you're in therapy currently, you could also experiment with having ChatGPT listen to you like your favorite type of therapist. So you could just say, act like an EFT therapist, act like a CBT therapist, whatever works for you. And of course, again, this is not like a real therapist, but I do think that for those who don't have the privilege of access to therapy, the comparison is not between, you know, ChatGPT and a real therapist, which is not a comparison, right? But ChatGPT and nothing at all, right? So feel free to experiment with it and see if it works for you. Now, if apart from online apps, you would also like more friends of you to listen empathically to you, but they keep talking about themselves, I have a video here about how to interrupt them and change that around.